वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम. गुड आफ्टरनून.
हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन,
गुड आफ्टरनून.
यस,
यस मैम.
ओके। जस्ट रिकॉल सिलेबस ऑफ 103 लास्ट ईयर, योर लास्ट ईयर सिलेबस ऑफ 103, एंड इन दैट सिलेबस यू आर लर्न अबाउट द मॉडल्स ऑफ टीचिंग। And today I'm going to start my session with one model, that is concept attainment model. Okay, so let me share my screen. Okay, screen is visible to everyone? Yes or no? Please reply.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
Can it not visible, Komal?
Ma'am, it is visible, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. See, I have displayed four images, you can say four pictures on this slide. Okay, just see all the pictures very carefully. Okay. We will give 5 seconds for this. Okay, now I'm going on the next slide. And my question is, if we want to categorize these images into two categories, then how we can categorize? See, knowingly, I have made two columns. You can say which are having two colors. The one is green and other is red. Okay. Now I'm going to categorize images in these two columns. So where you can categorize the images, I'm going to display the same images again. I give numbers to the images also, number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now it's your turn. Yes, we'll try to answer.
Hello ma'am, 2 and 3 pictures will go together and 1 and 4 picture will go together, I think.
Okay, Deepika.
I can explain it because in one picture, boys and girls both are sitting together and student ratio is very less. As okay. You can see on picture number 4, only girls are sitting and the strength is very low.
Okay.
But in the picture 2 and 3, the students, what we say, bahut jyada, matlab, so many students in the classroom. And in the 3 picture, boys are sitting, all the boys are sitting here and the girls are sitting that side. And the strength is very high.
Okay.
Strength.
Anyone want to answer? Yes. Thanks, Deepika.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, Komal.
Ma'am, personal attention is not possible when there is large number of students.
Okay, so just tell me how we can categorize. I want to categorize these images into two categories.
1 and 4 and 2 and 3, ma'am.
1 and 4 and 2 and 3. Is there any other answer?
Yes, ma'am. On the basis of strength of a classroom, we can divide these pictures into two categories. 1 and 4 in 1
okay.
category and 3 in 1 category.
Okay.
Where 3 is systemized, systematically arranged the classroom, where 2 is not systematically arranged classroom.
Okay, all answers are correct. But just try to recall the previous slide. Okay, I'm going on that slide. In which category? Suppose the first category, knowingly I painted that column with the green color and the other is with the red color. So where are we going to put the pictures? The picture number 1 and 4 and 2 and 3.
1 and 4 in green, 2 and 3 in red.
Okay. So these are the four pictures, and according to you, you're going to categorize all the four pictures into categories. You can call it as a zone, we can say. So picture number 1 and 4 in the green zone, and picture number 2 and 3 in the red zone, right? Okay. Any guesses about, in the previous lecture, we have studied various problems like problem of indiscipline, the problem of wastage, problem of stagnation. And today we are going to touch new educational problem. So any guesses about one more educational problem?
Crowded class or strength.
Okay.
Student teacher ratio.
Student teacher ratio.
Okay. Anyone want to answer?
Ma'am, activity based learning is happening in fourth picture.
Okay. See, we are going to find out particular topic, or we can say particular concept. So there we have to consider all the criteria. Don't stick to only one criteria.
Ma'am, okay. Effective and efficient teaching.
See, I got one answer. That was the overcrowded classroom, or you can say the crowded classroom. Okay, who gave that answer? I want your name, please.
Meenal.
Meenal, you're very right. So this is today's concept. That is crowded classroom, or clouded classes, you can say. And one more name is there, that is overcrowded classroom. Okay. See, I have displayed one more picture here. Can anyone read the... see, one line is there. Can anyone try to read? Yes. Chetna?
Yes, ma'am. effective teaching in an overcrowded class. Will it be possible? High school as a case study.
See, this picture, it is related to case study. One case study was there. And in this case study, this picture is added in that case study. Okay. Effective teaching in an overcrowded class. Would it be possible? So what is your answer?
No, ma'am.
Of course not. It is not possible.
Ma'am.
Do you able to read? So, see, something is written here.
Yeah, ma'am.
This round. Yes.
Class because of our
county enormous growth, we will be welcoming some new students today.
Okay. See, this picture is more explanatory. What teacher is saying? Class, because of our country's enormous growth, we will be welcoming some new students today. See the previous trend in the class. It is very, yes, we can say it is appropriate as per the class size, we can say. And now more students are entering in the same class. Then what will be the situation? Of course, the class will be overcrowded. Okay. Now tell me, so what do you mean by overcrowded? Yes. Overcrowded.
More than students. More than students.
See, do you think that is there any ideal class size? Means how these many number of students should be there in a particular class? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. According to government norms, there should be 30 to 35 students in the class.
Okay.
But here we can see overcrowded class means where the number of the students are more than is a standard norm.
As per the norms of the government of India, so 30, therefore they are saying the 30 students should be there in the one class. But if the number exceeds, then what we can say? There is a problem of, yes?
Crowded class.
Yes, there is a problem of overcrowded class. Okay. Please observe this slide very keenly and tell me what you understand after observing this.
Population increasing, that's why
but the funding is less.
Yes, Shubhangi?
Ma'am, the population is increasing, but the funding for such institutions is not increasing in that manner.
School are limited. Yeah. Increasing.
Yes. It's not proportionate, ma'am.
See, it's not proportionate, but here is increase in the population, and decrease in the funding. Okay. Yes. So here is the combination, and the result of the combination, it is here. The result of the combination of increasing population and decreasing funding, and that's the reason we are facing the issue of the crowded classes, and we can say the overcrowded classes or overcrowded classrooms. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to stop my screen sharing. I'm going to share the another screen. Okay. Is it visible to everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. See, as per the ideal world's class size, the basic, see, I'm talking about the ideal world's class size. So somewhere it is given 18, and somewhere it is given in the range that is 15 to 20. Okay. See the ideal class size. So I'm going to write in 15 to 20. Okay. When it exceeds, when you can say the particular classroom is overcrowded classroom, when it exceeds, yes, when it exceeds
ideal class size.
Yes, when it exceeds ideal class size. Ideal class size. Yes. And nowadays, as per the government of India, the ideal class size should be, yes, what Meenal says? Yes, Meenal, ideal class size.
30 to 35.
Should be between 30 to 35.
Yes, ideal class size is 30 to 35. So in directly you can say when the class size is more than 30 to 35, or you can say when it exceeds than 30 to 35 students in a particular class, then you can say that class is overcrowded class. Okay. So this is the basic concept of the overcrowded class, or you can say, see, you can use different names for these: crowded classes, crowded classrooms, overcrowded classes, and overcrowded classrooms. Okay. So this is the basic concept about the crowded class. See, this is we are saying that this is one issue, or this is one problem we can see in the secondary and in the higher secondary stage. Okay. So this is the one biggest problem, and because of this issue, or we can say because of this problem of overcrowded classroom, there are so many problems created. So let's see what problems they are created because of this particular issue. Okay, now it's your turn. Just tell me one by one. So which problem? So that problems they can see. Basically, who suffers if there is a problem of the overcrowded classroom? First, we have to consider the peoples. So here, basically, who suffers because of the overcrowded classroom? Yes?
Students.
Yes, the most suffers, the students, they more suffers. Okay, then only students, they suffer
teacher,
because...
Teacher, obviously.
Of course, teachers means the basic...
Teacher, ma'am.
Yes, the students, teachers, and school as well. Okay, so these three physical factors, they suffers because of the overcrowded classroom. Okay, so just consider the student, teachers, and the schools. And by considering students, teachers, and schools, now tell me which problems created by the overcrowded classroom. Now it's your turn.
Nowadays, not concentration in class. Okay. Concentration less.
We can say less concentration in the classroom.
Yes, ma'am. Noisy classroom, ma'am.
Yes, noisy classroom.
No proper attention. No proper attention.
That is less concentration. Both are the same. Okay. Yes, Sonali.
Ma'am, proper arrangement of classroom.
Yes, the seating arrangement.
Ma'am, misbehave.
Indiscipline.
Yeah, discipline or misbehave in the class.
You can say indiscipline or misbehavior.
Improper effective teaching.
Misbehavior in the class. Then next, what was the next?
Ineffective teaching.
Yes.
Increasing of stagnation.
Okay. Very nice. Increasing stagnation problem, we can say.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, try to tell me some more problems. See, consider the problem is faced by the students, the problem faced by the teacher, and problems faced by the schools.
Ma'am, teacher cannot give attention to a particular student.
Okay, so we can say the personal instructions are not possible, we can say. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm as seeing the current situation, if the population is more in the same place, at one place, the spreading of disease, we have social distancing maintain kar rahe hain jaise, so number of the student agar zyada rahenge ek place pe to disease hone ka khatra zyada rahega, like health issue ho sakte hain.
See, now it's turn of the science students, those who are from the science background. So now tell me the where we can categorize some diseases. They spreads immediately through the touch.
Influenza, cough, cold, normal flu.
Contagious flu, and non-contagious.
Yes.
Chances.
Yes.
To increase the immunity.
Yes. Yes. Who gave me that answer? That is contagious and non-contagious.
Shubhangi.
Yes. Shubhangi, ma'am. Very nice. So the spread of, we can say, contagious diseases possible.
Ma'am, effect on academic?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Effect on academics like this.
Effects on... See, effects on academics, that is true. But which student suffers more? Okay. Your answer is true. Answer is right. Effects on academics. Yes. See, basically three types of students are there. Some are the high achievers, some are the we can say they are having the middle intellectual level, or some students are having the, we can say, low achievers. Instead of saying the low intellectual level, you can say low achievers are there, and the middle students are there, you can say. So which students they suffers more according to you?
Poor and average, below average students, ma'am.
Actually, now I want answer from your side. Why?
Ma'am, they are not able to concentrate more in the noise, because such students need more attention, or they need...
So you can say the low achievers?
Yes.
Low achievers suffers more. Low achievers?
Yes. Ma'am, even the testing scores or the standard tests, they might get affected because of crowded class. I mean, the teacher will not be able to conduct all the tests so efficiently. Agar unko oral exam lena hai 10 logo ka aur 50 logo ka, so there is a difference.
Of course, there is a difference. So what we can say? The standardized test score suffers, we can say?
Yes, yes.
Improper development, moral values.
Yes, 1 minute, Sonali. Yes, standardized test score suffers, we can say. Yes, Sonali, please repeat your answer. Sonali? Actually, your voice is not top.
Of moral values in this brand.
Yes, yes.
Is it audible, ma'am?
No, I'm not getting your voice clearly.
So improper development.
Oh, you can say the problem with the value education, you can say? Yes,
ma'am. I think she say improper development.
Improper development regarding what?
I don't know, but I listen only this word.
Okay.
Moral value, ma'am.
Yes, moral value. So what we can say? So what will be the correct, which word, correct word we can use for that?
Ethics, ma'am.
I think affects on the value education, we can say. Affect on
yes,
value
ma'am.
Education, that value will be the right word.
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, I want some other answers. Please try to record. Just consider teachers, school and students.
Ma'am, is there a possibility that because of the less space in the class due to more number of students,
mm-hmm.
We cannot accommodate the apparatus or the equipment that are required?
Yeah, that is very true. See, most of the time, you might have saw different schools.
Yes,
they are not providing proper science laboratories, even proper computer laboratories, because
yes.
For conducting classes they are not having enough space. Okay.
Yes.
So, automatically, so what we can say?
Less space for equipments and
yes, less. You can say less access to equipment.
Yes.
Yes, less access to equipment. Yes. Just try to think and tell me some more problems. Once we find the problems, so it is very easy for us to find the remedies or to find the solutions on this.
Ma'am, teachers may feel frustrated. Their stress level may increase.
Yes.
And they may leave the job also sometimes.
Of course. Very nice answer. Sanjoda, very nice answer. So what we can write? Yes.
Stress level of teachers, kind of.
You can say the teacher stress is increased. You can say yes. Teacher burnout.
Yes, ma'am. Burnout is the right word.
Teacher stress level increased. And teacher, I'm just writing slash there. Teacher burnout. Okay, try to recall some more.
Ma'am, students can't able to see the blackboard properly, what ma'am can write or not.
Yes. Students not able to see blackboard. See, instead of that, you see all these points comes under where we can add these points. Effect on learning, we can say. And there you can give one example, that is, it is not possible for the all students to see blackboard, or if the teacher is doing any kind of experimentation in front of the student, it is not possible for the student to see that experimentation. Okay, so it's effects on learning. See, I remember one of my students when she met us, I think 1 or 2 years before, and she is doing job in particular school, and that school is having the same problem, that is the overcrowded classrooms. Okay, and when she quite healthy, and when she enters in the classroom, she enter like twist hoke wo enter hoti thi classroom mein, kyunki jaise ki wo enter hoti thi usko hilne ke liye wahan pe jagah nahi thi. तो डायरेक्ट वो पहले एंटर होने के टाइम पे भी पहले ही फेस कहाँ पे करती थी, ब्लैक बोर्ड की तरफ करती थी, और वैसे ही तिर के बच्चों की तरफ देखती थी, वैसे ही एंट्री मारती थी. सो इट्स हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ द लेस प्लेस, क्योंकि नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स आर मोर. सो व्हाट स्कूल्स दे आर डूइंग, दे आर अरेंजिंग मोर बेंचेस इन द पर्टिकुलर क्लासरूम, एंड देर इज नो प्रॉपर स्पेस फॉर द टीचर्स टू मूव. ओके, सो दीज आर द प्रॉब्लम्स, अंडरस्टूड? सो व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स क्रिएटेड बाय द one issue, that is the overcrowded classroom, or we can say crowded classes. Okay, now tell me which remedies or which solutions we can apply to overcome this problem. Now problem is in front of you. Now tell me the solutions. Yes, just think. I will give you 1 minute for that. Yes,
the student teacher ratio would appropriate. Sorry,
it's okay.
See, is it really possible? Because see, this overcrowded classroom problem is there. It is only because of the population and the low funding. Okay, so is it possible to maintain the student teacher ratio?
अगर पहले से अगर ओवरक्राउडेड क्लास तो वी कैन डू वन थिंग दैट 30 से ज्यादा है तो दो क्लास फॉर प्राइमरी लेवल दो टीचर्स रख सकते हैं.
यस दैट इज द राइट आंसर. सो अरेंजमेंट ऑफ व्हाट कैन से अरेंजमेंट ऑफ
टीचर्स
वेल नोन कॉन्सेप्ट. वी कैन से the arrangement of co-teacher. If we in most of the schools there are two teachers, the main teacher and the co-teacher. So this co-teacher assists the main teacher. So it helps in the classroom management for the main teacher, and the co-teacher also learn many things from the main teacher. Okay, tell me other solutions. Yes
ma'am, we can divide the classroom into two parts so how? That we can concentrate effective teaching.
Okay, Komal, suppose you are a teacher of a particular class, and as a teacher, you are also facing that class is overcrowded classroom, and you are facing the same problem. Okay, so how you can divide the classroom into two parts, and which kind of teaching techniques you can apply on that? Yes, Komal?
In higher secondary, we can divide a classroom into A and B, so that one teacher can handle one class and another one can handle second one.
See, the basic thing is, suppose the one teacher is teaching on a particular class and the class size is 60 to 70. Okay, but as per the norms, what norms are saying, the class size, it should be 30 to 35. So as per your opinion, there should be two divisions, or you can say the two classes should be there. But it is possible to conduct for a single teacher to conduct two classes simultaneously?
No, ma'am.
So there is a need of one more teacher, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So who will suffer here?
Yes, ma'am.
Who will suffer here?
Teacher.
Teacher, ma'am.
School suffer क्योंकि school को recruit करना पड़ेगा फिर.
Yes, yes.
School need more funding. अभी एक teacher से काम हो रहा है तो वहाँ पे उनको दूसरा teacher लेना पड़ेगा.
Yes,
मैम, यहाँ पे फिर हम मतलब शिफ्ट में कर सकते हैं क्या? मतलब अगर स्कूल में मतलब एक क्लास में क्राउडिंग हो रहा है तो कुछ बच्चे मतलब आजकल शिफ्ट में भी जाते हैं कि सुबह एक शिफ्ट दोपहर को एक शिफ्ट, फिर टीचर भी एक रहेगा, स्कूल को ज्यादा फंडिंग भी नहीं करनी पड़ेगी और बच्चे भी अच्छे से पढ़ेंगे.
योगिता, नाउ माय क्वेश्चन इज टू यू. सो एज अ टीचर आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस बीएड कोर्स यू विल एंटर इन एनी स्कूल एज अ टीचर. ओके, suppose your organization or your school expect from you that you have to do your job in the morning shift and in the afternoon shift also. Is it possible for you on the same payment you can do the job on the both the shifts?
No, not the same. same payment तो नहीं करेंगे मैम, लेकिन अगर एक्स्ट्रा पेमेंट कुछ स्कूल वाले करते हैं, आपको एक्स्ट्रा पे करते हैं, लेकिन आप करो
फॉर दैट पॉसिबल हो सकता है. फॉर दैट वी कैन से दैट द ट्यूटरिंग फैसिलिटी वी कैन अरेंज फॉर द लो अचीवर्स. ओके, सो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू गिव पर्सनल इंस्ट्रक्शंस. सो एज यू टोल्ड मी दैट मोस्टली हु सफर्स द लो अचीवर्स और द मिडल लेवल, वी कैन से एवरेज स्टूडेंट्स, दे कैन सफर्स. So for them, we can arrange extra attention, or we can say the remedial teaching we can arrange, or we can arrange extra tutorial classes for them. Okay, so that can be one remedy. Okay, you can say tutoring students, low achievers, or we can say low achievers and average students, you can say.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. tell me some more solutions. This is very challenging task for you to find out the solutions on this problem. Can we suppose there are two divisions? Suppose particular school is having two divisions, and if we see the strength of both the divisions is nearby 50. Okay, the strength is 50. And if we see, as you all know, basically three category students are there: the high achievers, low achievers, and the average students are there. So can we categorize like those who need more attention? Now, who is Hello? The host of this meeting? Let me know, please. Meenakshi Sharma, please make me host so that I can share my screen. Okay, thank you. Meenakshi, please. Okay, thank you. Okay, now tell me some more. Screen is visible to everyone? Yes?
No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Now, yes, ma'am. Your turn. Tell me some more remedies. You can say solution.
Ma'am, I was saying.
Yes.
Ma'am, I was saying, Shubhangi, even.
Yes,
Shubhangi. I was saying that can we make the teacher can make the students sit on a rotational basis. Like
yes.
The last very bencher nice. Wala first bench pe aa gaya.
Last, what you can say? What will be the correct word for that? We can say the assigning seats are rotating when necessary.
Yes, sitting arrangement.
Yeah. Simply we can say sitting arrangement.
Ma'am, keep everyone.
Yeah.
Yes.
Ma'am, keep everyone busy in work.
Keep everyone busy in
work.
We can say activity more focus on the. We can say more focus. Focus on the activity-based learning. Yes, we can say like this.
Activity. Yes,
yes, ma'am. Activity-based learning.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, sitting arrangement, how we can, what kind of sitting arrangement we can do for those students when there is a problem of the overcrowded classroom? Yes.
Yes, ma'am, low achievers ko hum aage bita sakte. We can make them sit in the front. The low achievers or the average students more so that they can.
Okay, thank you, Shubhangi. You gave a very nice answer. That was actually I was expecting. So those who are low achievers, so we can say the average student, they can sit in front, and the remaining student, they can sit on the back benches. Okay, so that it is easy for the teacher to give personal instructions to the students those who really need it. Okay, yes. Give me some more solutions. Yes,
ma'am. Teachers may use mic or speakers so that all children can listen their voice.
You can say use of technical aids.
Yeah,
so all these are the technical aids, right? You can see.
Yes, ma'am.
Technical instead of technical, you can say audio visual aids. That will be the right word. Use of audio visual. Aids. Okay. Some more answers I want. Yes. Yes, Komal.
Ma'am, I think teacher should plan the lesson very smartly. Actually, she cannot keep on talking for 30 minutes. She'll have to keep it jaise short rakhna padega and more of activity dena padega. Matlab, she'll have to smartly plan the
okay, that will come under activity-based learning. So, focus should be given on the activity-based learning. So, teacher planning comes under this point. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, see.
Ma'am?
Yes, Shubhangi?
Ma'am? Yogita, ma'am.
Yes, Yogita.
मैम हम मतलब मॉनिटर कर सकते हैं बच्चे मतलब बच्चों को मॉनिटर करने के लिए बोल सकते
हैं ऑफकोर्स we can say the monitoring system. Yes, ye kya hoga normally kya karte hai jo monitors rehte hai wo like they are acting like जब जब भी जरूरत पड़ती थी। आप यहाँ पे बेसिकली क्या होता है, आप लोगों को बोले कि बहुत नॉइज होता है, जब जैसे कि बहुत सारे बच्चे एक ही क्लास में है, दे आर मेकिंग मोर नॉइज। सो हु आर मेकिंग एक्चुअल नॉइज, कौन कौन शोर शोर कौन करता है क्लास में?
नॉटी बच्चे।
सो नॉटी, सी दैट वाज, दैट इज
मॉनिटर,
सी दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर, नॉटी बच्चे। सो नॉटी बच्चे लोअर अचीवर्स, अचीवर्स दे कैन बी नॉटी, mid average students they can be naughty, even the intellectual students or we can say high achievers, they can also naughty. So naughty students they can make more noise in the classroom. So as per the need of the students, for example, the teacher is giving the classes of mathematics class, and teacher is teaching suppose profit and loss in the class, okay, and first he taught them about the profit and loss, and she gave some more examples for the dealing purpose. Okay, so what will happen here, the students, they are having high intellectual ability, they will solve particular example immediately, and so other they require some more time. So what will happen, that boy, or we can say that particular student, after completion of his work, what he will do, he will distract others, he will make noise. Okay, so at that time it's the duty of a teacher to make that particular students in, क्या करना चाहिए उसको?
Monitor.
Yes, उसको monitor बनाओ, उसको assist करने के लिए बोलो, जिनको example समझ में नहीं आया है या फिर उनको कहीं कुछ help की जरूरत है, that particular student can assist the other student. Okay? Okay, do you remember any other solution for this? Yes. See, the basically the problem of this overcrowded classroom, it is only because of the increasing in the population and lowering the funding. The funds are very low. So here the school should think about the more funding. So that is also one solution we can say. So from where they will get more funding? Yes. Yes.
From government body or management, administrative department should be taken care for this.
Yes, that is true. But from where they will get funding? उनके पास fund नहीं, जिसकी वजह से तो ये problem खड़ी हुई है. लेकिन अगर उनको ऐसे लगता है कि एक class में इतने सारे बच्चे नहीं होने चाहिए, तो उनके लिए ज्यादा क्लासेस चाहिए, तो ज्यादा क्लासेस चाहिए, ज्यादा फंड चाहिए, क्योंकि ज्यादा टीचर चाहिए, तो फंड कहाँ से रेज करेंगे वो? सो हियर दे कैन टेक हेल्प ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, दे कैन टेक हेल्प ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, यस, पॉलिसीज, दे कैन टेक
पॉलिसीज, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसीज, एजुकेशन,
यस, दे कैन टेक हेल्प ऑफ गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसीज. आप जब भी देखोगे गवर्नमेंट ने बहुत सारा, जैसे कि जस्ट समवन टोल्ड मी अबाउट द यूज ऑफ द ऑडियो विजुअल एड्स. सो गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइडिंग ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, लाइक कंप्यूटर्स दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग, द साउंड
सिस्टम,
यस, दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग
मेनी स्मार्ट क्लास. मैम शुड बी इजी इन फॉर ओवरक्राउडेड क्लासेस,
यस, दैट विल कम अंडर ऑडियो विजुअल एड्स. So that smart,
yes,
the smart board, that is also one kind of audio visual aid, we can say. And one more thing, suppose the administrator, okay, administrator, so it can be any trustee member, we can say. If administrator, if he visiting the school regularly, then maybe he will come to know the problem arises due to the overcrowded classroom. अगर उनको खुद पता चलेगा कि नहीं ओवरक्राउडेड क्लासरूम है जिसकी वजह से ये प्रॉब्लम्स हो रहे, दे विल थिंक अबाउट द सॉल्यूशंस आल्सो. ओके, सो व्हाट वी कैन से, सो व्हाट वी कैन राइट हियर, यस,
लॉबी फॉर फंडिंग,
यस. Lobby for funding. Okay, understood the different solutions, yes or no? this is very simple topic. You should know the basic concept of overcrowded classroom, and because of that particular issues, there are creation of so many problems, and the problems are like less concentration of the students, more noise in the classroom, student may fail the problem with the sitting arrangement, there is an indiscipline in the classroom, so that the student, they misbehave in the class. Because of this, teachers, they are also not doing their job properly. So you can say ineffective teaching. Because of this problem, there may be problem of stagnation also. It is not possible for the teachers to give personal attention towards the students. Even the spread of contagious diseases, it is possible because of the overcrowded classroom. It also affect on the effect of the academics of the students, we can say. And mostly here, who suffers? Low achievers, and you can say the average students suffers. The standardized test scores also suffers. It affects on the value education. There is a lack access of the equipment because no place in the classroom. So it is not possible for the teacher to use different equipments for the teaching, which actually assist the teaching of this teacher. And see, if there is a no proper teaching, we can say ineffective teaching, then of course there is a no learning in the classroom. Teacher stress level, most of the time what happens, suppose the time period is 30 to 30 minutes, okay? And teacher plans, for example, within these 30 minutes, I'm going to teach this particular lesson, that is the clouded classes, okay? But because of that problem, that is overcrowded classroom, most of the time, even we can think about the best teacher. In the previous lectures also, you told me about the skillful teacher should be required or experienced teacher should be required. So here we can say the best teacher or the skillful teacher or the experienced teacher. So even these teachers, they also fail to control the overcrowded classroom because they have to spend more time in the controlling the particular classroom. Okay. And these are the solutions. See, arrangement of the co-teachers. One co-teacher should be there. Then the tutoring with the students. So when teacher give tutoring, so after completion of the school, there may be extra classes. There may be arrangement of the extra classes for the low achievers, or you can say the average students. We can change the sitting arrangement. The sitting arrangement, the for the low achievers and the for the average students, they can sit in front in the class, and the others, they can sit in the back side. Okay, more focus should be given on the activity based learning, so teacher keeps busy students in the learning activities. Use of the audio visual aids, so here we can, if we are, the teacher is using audio visual aids, so we can fulfill the needs of the all kinds of learner, auditory, visual, audio visual learners. Okay, use of the monitoring system. So here the monitor, what he is doing, the monitor is doing a work like a assistant teacher. Okay, the school should think about more funding, because this problem is only because of the funding and the population. So school should think about the more funding. Schools, they should take help of the government policies, and they should find the lobby for the funding. I think these two points, they are same. I wrote it twicely. Okay, so these are the solutions regarding this problem of the overcrowded classroom. Understood the entire topic? Yes or no? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If you have any query, please ask. Yes. Any query from your side? No query? Understood the entire topic? Yes or no?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. In fact, if the answer we can write like is at a school level, at a class level, both overcrowded class impacts on both, right?
Of course, not
only classroom the management, we also disturb over and school management.
Yes. See, so basically, who suffers in the initial, initially I told you about who suffers, the students, teachers, and the school. So whatever you are writing, you have to consider all these three factors, you can say. You have to consider students, you have to consider teachers, and school as well, you have to consider. Okay? Okay, Minal? Yes?
Yes, yes.
Okay?
Thank you.
Okay, now this is 3:19. So am I in my lecture? You want to ask me something more about the same topic? Yes or no?
No, ma'am. It's clear.
Okay. Thank you so much. Now I'm going to end up this meeting. Thank you. See you in the next session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.